Hello guys, in my last video you watched the amazing update of the Adobe Photoshop 2020. Those were updated last week. Like that, Adobe updated both Lightroom CC and Lightroom Classic with the huge updates. So don't skip this video and must watch the beautiful updates that help you in your workflow. What is new in Lightroom? Now Lightroom Classic come with the new LRC logo and Lightroom CC come with the LR logo. Where Adobe improve its performance, there it also add very useful features like ISO adaptive preset. Let's watch. With the one-click ISO adaptive preset, you can control the noise for the pictures of a different ISO speeds regardless the camera model. I love this feature and it will help me a lot in my workflow. I am importing an image of a 400 ISO and removing its noise by simply going to the detail menu. Increase the luminous value to 62 to reduce the noise. After that noise was removed, now time to create a preset. Here one thing to remember, the preset I am creating with a single image, it will not work with the different ISO speeds. So we need to have at least two images of a different ISO to create this ISO adaptive preset. So I am importing here three images of a different ISO speeds. First image has 8000 ISO and second one has a 400 ISO. The last image is my base image and its ISO is 200. First, I am selecting the image with the ISO 8000. Move the luminance slider to 67. The value depends on your choice and the level of the noise. After that, I selected the image with the ISO 400. Definitely, it has a less noise, so value should not be the same as a 67. So I set the value to 27 and it is good for this picture. In the last image, with the ISO 200 has no noise, so I did not change anything with this picture, value remaining on the zero. Now select the all images and go to the plus sign on the top of the preset menu and create a new preset. I named it My ISO Adaptive Preset. Uncheck the all other options, just check on the noise reduction and don't forget to check the ISO setting box, then create. Now we have the three images with the value of 67. 27 and 0 according to the 8400 and 200 ISO respectively. Now I am importing a three new images on the Lightroom. First image has ISO 6400 and it is showing the visible noise. I am going to the user preset and select the ISO adaptive preset that I have already created. Boom! Noise was removed with the one click. And the beautiful innovation is that we set the value 67 for the 8000 ISO. But with the 6400 ISO, Lightroom automatically set the value to 64 because this image ISO speed is less than ISO 8000. See this with the 8000, it was a 67. So like that, I am selecting another image with the ISO 640. It is obvious ISO 640 will have less noise than the 6400. So let's check what happened when we use preset on 640 ISO. It's great. It's set to 33 automatically. So it means Lightroom automatically adapt the ISO range. In the last, I am selecting the image with the ISO 100. When I select the My ISO adaptive preset on the ISO 100, Lightroom did nothing. And that's what we want. Because you have no need to remove noise with the ISO 100 or 200 image. You can also set your preset as your default. In the default preset menu, go to the preferences, go to the preset. Drop down the menu and set the default preset My ISO adaptive preset instead of Adobe default or camera setting. So when you open the new image with the higher ISO, then your base ISO is 200 or below. Lightroom automatically reduces the noise according to the ISO range. It is a very handy feature. Now I am again set the preferences to the camera settings. Now if you open image in Lightroom, it will not reduce noise automatically. You need to select the My ISO adaptive preset. If you select the My ISO adaptive preset, noise will be reduced automatically. See the difference before and after. Now I am saving this preset for you. You can download it from my website and import it in your Lightroom. I have already inserted a link in the description. When you save my preset to your computer, then you need to go to the preset menu, then click on plus, then select import preset, select the location where you copied the preset, click OK. Preset will be resigned to your user preset menu where you can use anytime. With this release, you will also experience the performance improvements like searching and filtering large numbers of collections, scrolling through your catalog grid in the library module using arrow keys, mouse, trackpad or touch, most noticeable with the larger catalogs. The UI for the selecting a color in the color panel has also been updated. The UI for the tone curves has been updated in this release, making it easier to switch between parametric and point curve channels. You can now make more precise adjustment with the input values for the point curves and the red, green and the blue channels. Another new feature is a local hue adjustment. The local adjustment tool, adjustment brush, radial filter and graduate filter, go to the hue slider added to the roster of the available adjustments. The top bar of the slider is the reference hue bar and the bottom bar is the hue slider. The hue slider and the center color of the hue slider is based on the color from the selected area. You can select use fine adjustment option to precise adjustments. This is handy when you want to shift the hue of a color in a localized region of the photo without affecting that the same color in other places. Checking the Use Fine Adjustment box under the Hue Adjustment can also prevent wild hue shifts from happening, especially helpful when working with the skin. That's all for today. I am waiting your feedback for my ISO Attractive preset works. Soon I will come again with a new tutorial. Thanks for watching.